ลำน้ำแม่ลาเนี่ยมีความอุดมสมบูรณ์ดินดีน้ำดีสภาพแวดล้อมดีทำให้ปลาที่อยู่อาศัยในลำน้ำแม่ลาเนี่ยมีรสชาติอร่อย
It's the first time to see the farm snakehead real fish. I think I'm a country boy. I had a lot of hands on the wildlife fish and thing, but this is my first time to see how they feed the fish. I'm very fascinating how things gonna be around here. So we see how much they can develop. Yeah.
Canvas, we use all ingredients from Thailand, but we don't make Thai food, so it's something kind of new. We did one dish a long time ago. It was like a poached snakehead fish. I don't really know much about it, so we'll try to cook it and taste it and hopefully catch some.
It become a very, very common for plachon in Thailand. You know, I would say the whole country that we've been eating plachon.Do you have a snakehead fish in U.S.?
We have snakehead fish, but it is an invasive species. You know what I mean? So people don't really know what to do with it, and I think that maybe chefs could try to cook with it a little bit. There's definitely some things that I'm interested in trying, but I want to learn from you too. I need to know the traditional way before I can try to do something new.
I'm gonna cook traditional first, and we share the idea. Let both of us inspire to do something new. It may be not the best, whatever, but I think we can experiment a new way of something, experiment as well.
ลักษณะปลาช่อนปลาช่อนแม่ลาแท้ๆเนี่ยก็จะตัวสีขาวขุ่นตัวอ้วนหัวหลิมขี้สีชมพูหางใบพัดตะลับปัดแล้วหลังขี้หูนี่จะสีส้มบนชมพูลักษณะเฉพาะจะไม่เหมือนเขาอันนี้คือเลี้ยงระยะกลางเอาไว้ทำปลาแดดเดียวไว้ทำต้มยำเอาไว้ทำอาหารเมนูหลากหลาย
So he's saying you know the small size restaurant around here they always choose that to do a deep fry because the bone is kind of like soft
so you can eat the bone I got two ideas and one of them is we can try to cook it at a low temperatureEither sous vide or poaching, like 65 degrees, and seeing if the texture is going to be a little bit different than some of the traditional methods. I also like the name snakehead fish. And when you think about snakehead fish, I think about other things that are snake-like. And in Thailand, there's buab, snake gourd.
Yeah.
So I think maybe we'll try to use some snake gourd with the snakehead.
To be honest, I never thought with the buab for me. Never thought about it. Never at all. But I mean, something came up with your idea.You're gonna catch something, and I aim for that.
The big one? You want the big one? I want the big one.
Okay.
So tell me what you got over here.
Yeah, I got a soy, and I add some of the lemongrass. But we're gonna add some this one, the nam pala, a little bit.Just like to get it binding together. This one we got it homemade. So basically like we put a lot of salt and khao bua, also roasted rice, boy, lemongrass, coffee lime, a lot of things.
Pala is something new for me. I learned that I like it earlier this year. I didn't always like it before, but I tasted it earlier this year. I was like, it's delicious. This is an awesome idea to me, and it really is something that I want to use on the menu now.
Okay,
Yeah, I'm thinking about it. I'm grilling buab over here. We're gonna grill it whole, then make a sauce for the snakehead fish with some pickled garlic. Something a little bit different. Get a little bit of smokiness and creamy into it.
It's very different because this ingredient with plachon, it's totally like Thai people never get hands on. You know.
I just like the idea of having snake fish, snakehead fish with snake gourd.
Oh yeah, yeah. Just like you told me. Oh, okay. Cool.My ones we call mok plachon, so we kind of like wraps in banana leaf with pala, you know, fermented fish. We cook that and then it's dehydrated with the bone, so you can pick up with the chip. And this one is tam bak sida and tam, so you can have to go together. Not unlikely like traditional taste of the Isan, but I still keep the traditional of the way of cooking like mok and wrap, cook, put the soy.And eat together. So that's my dish inspired from that.
It looks delicious. It smells delicious.
Happy.
This is snakehead fish that we confit, and we thought it'd be fun to serve it with a snake gourd. So we have a puree of that with some pickled garlic.
Oh, this one, yeah.
We've also made a paste from pea eggplant with wild pepper leaf or bai chapu, telling thing for a little bit of sourness. There's some fried chakram and also some spirulina. So it's a lot of briny things, and that matches the flavor of the fish. You'll get a little bit of smokiness, some creaminess. There's also a little bit of spice coming from green peppercorn.
All right, we're gonna exchange in them.
Super nice.
It's unlike for me that you get for the technique of the sous vide. This is my first time that you go for like beyond for what I thought, a sous vide, the plachon, you know, snakehead fish. And the texture is like, you know, crab meat, a little bit from there, the creaminess from the sauce. It's just a perfect marriage for me.
This one is all of the Thai flavors together, yeah. And it's perfectly balanced. And sometimes it's not always balanced as well as this one is. It's beautiful.
I hope you will play with that. Spicy.
You should put this on your menu tonight. So I learned a lot from you. I learned a lot about snakehead and also more traditional ways of cooking with it, which isn't something that I know a lot about. I know more about modern. For me, I am always trying to learn more about the ingredients here. And I feel like there's so much out there to learn about. A lot of times I'm busy in my kitchen in Bangkok, like 6 days a week, but there's amazing things all over Thailand. That's really the reason why I moved here like 4 years ago, was to try to cook with these ingredients and do something a little bit different. So I want to go see more.
You know, like I've been so many places. The more I have been, the more I learned that I have not been here, been there, know this, know that before. Because so many places that we need to be, you know, like go there, visit and discover is about it. And I'm sure, you know, like take someone, you know, take me, for instance, go there, and you know, we can explore a lot of things, because the food is not just about the taste, it's based on the culture. I think that's the amazing of Thailand.